What's up guys, so in this video I'm going to teach you exactly how to set up content silos for SEO. So if you want to increase your rankings, if you want to get more traffic, if you want to rank higher on Google, then content silos are a very powerful part of this, especially for on-page SEO, because they'll help improve your site's architecture, help you get crawled by Google easier, and it's going to take your website to another level. So in this video we'll teach you exactly how to do that. By the way, if you have any questions about content silos and how they work, then feel free to drop a comment below and I'll be happy to help you. Right, so let's say you've already done your keyword research. You have a list of keywords you want to organize into silo content. Basically, this is about categorizing your content and making it as easy as possible for Google to crawl your site. Now, basically, as you can see, you've got a raw list of keywords here, but if you can organize them better, then you can create related pages that are in subcategories. So for example, we've got best cat food at the top here. So what you could do is turn this into a bullet list, and then you could have a subcategory for food and put all your related keywords related to food under that section, and that would be your first silo. So we could do best cat food brands, best cat food for indoor cats, and we can put those as pages underneath main hub content, which is food. And then what you could actually do on your website is have a category page for food on your site, and then it would be much easier for Google to crawl your site. Plus your site architecture would be a lot more organized too. And then we can take other examples too, right? So you can see we've got quite a few keywords around litter. So we could have a subcategory of litter and silo content underneath that. And just organize it like this. So basically, once you've already done your keyword research, and if you don't know how to do that already, check out some of my other video tutorials. But once you've done your keyword research, you can organize it into subcategories, into silo content. And all you need is a simple like Google document to do this. Like you just put it in bullet points and indent any sort of keywords under the main category. And then the next step will be to go through the whole list and to sort all of them into silos so that you've got your whole architecture set up for the website before you publish the content. Now it's important to get this right, because before you start publishing content, you should have a plan of where you're going to silo your content first. Because if you don't, the more content you publish on your site, the messier your architecture is going to get, and the longer it's going to take to fix that and to organize it and potentially even redirect some URLs. So it's better to do this from the start, especially if you have a new website. Now, what you can also do, if you go to a keyword tool like Ahrefs, for example, you can type in your keyword, for example, like best cat food, pop it into the keyword explorer like that, click on overview, and it's just going to fetch the data. But once it's done that, essentially you're going to get a list of the keywords and the competitors that are ranking for this keyword, but also the parent topic too. And the parent topic is potentially a new hub for you, right? Or you could find related keywords to your silo that you've missed already. So you can see here, top keyword is best cat food. So if we click on that, and then we go to matching terms, phrase match, you'll see a ton of other keywords that we could include under the silo content of food. So best cat food for indoor cats, best cat food for brands. So Ahrefs is a very useful tool for categorizing your silo content, finding new keywords that you've missed, and looking at your competitors' content, seeing what's ranking already, and looking at the parent topic of each keyword too. So the next step as well you want to do with silo content is check what are your competitors doing as well, because that's a great place not just to see some good examples of how to silo away your content, but also to see if you've missed any keywords too. So what you can do is, if we take cat food for example, we're going to take a look at petsradar.com, and you can see already in their URL structure they've got petsradar.com, and then they've categorized the silo content into buying guides. And then under buying guides, they have different pages around buying pet products, right? So that gives you an idea of how you can silo your content. For example, if you have a pets review site or if you have a cat review site, then you could silo your content under buying guides. And the thing is as well, there's no like right or wrong way to do this. It's about progress, not perfection. And you don't have to get it 100% right. It's just about making sure that you have some sort of structure, some sort of organization in place to make sure that Google can crawl your site easier. And you'll get better at this with time. You know, the more experience you have, the easier it's going to be for you to identify what are your best silo content pages. How can you organize your hubs? So if we check out their site, for example, we can see that even from their menu bar, they've siloed different content. So they've got news, they've got videos, advice, cats, dogs, health, and buying guides. So that gives you an idea of how you could silo your content too. For example, if your site's about cats, then you could have at the top menu bar, toys, buying guides, litter, that sort of thing. And you can basically organize your content structure like this. Now, what I also want to show you is how to optimize your URL structure for your silos too. And there's two ways to do this, right? So the first way is if you go to your posts, for example, you can create category pages and put your silos in there. For example, like, you know, categories could be organized under buying guides, under, for this website, it's chipperbirds.com, so it could be like bird buying guides, birds advice, general knowledge, that sort of thing. And then under your posts, you can categorize the URL structure based on those sort of subcategories. Now, another way to do this is if you go to settings and then you go to permalinks in WordPress, you can actually change the structure, right? So you can put a custom structure like this and actually put like chipperbirds.com/ the category and then the URL. And that's a good way to have the silo URL name before you have the main URL name. So it could be like chipperbirds.com/ buying guides /. Best binoculars for bird watching. And that's an easy way for you to structure your URLs on your website to make sure that your silo content is as organized as possible. And the thing to remember here is, well, as your website expands, as you publish more content, you can have more categories, you can have more silo content. This means that you should really plan your site architecture before you publish any content. Thanks for watching, guys. So that teaches you exactly how content silos work and how to implement them on your site. By the way, if you're interested in getting higher rankings, increasing your traffic from SEO, and taking your website to another level, then feel free to book in a call via my website, juliangoldie.com. I run a link building agency. And if you book in a call now, we'll teach you exactly how to get more traffic with link building and a tried, tested, and proven link building strategy that we can quickly implement on your site to get you better rankings. So that's at juliangoldie.com. Feel free to book in a free consultation there and we'll be happy to help you. Thanks.